Good morning, I'm David Bragdon. Welcome back to Outlook Portland. My guests this morning are Eric Schneider, owner and director of Quality Pictures in Northwest Portland, and Holly Andrus, who's been described as Portland's most celebrated young photographer. I know you've declined that, but let's let that stand. And you know, a few weekends ago this summer, I was walking through Northwest Portland, walked into your gallery, and saw this exhibition, Sparrow Lane, that Holly had done. I said, wow, there is some kind of interesting story here. And like to have the photographer and the gallery owner come share it here. Tell us a little about what the actual story is in terms of narrative photography.
Well, I'll let Holly expand on it, but Sparrow Lane sort of is a story that's sort of loosely based on Nancy Drew, maybe a Nancy Drew mystery. And each of the individual images in this particular exhibition could easily be read as chapters in the story, isn't that right?
Sure.
And so where does this stuff come from?
Well, you know, I like to think of the body of work as these characters. It's an elliptical narrative that isn't supposed to be read in a linear way per se. And they're embarking on some sort of forbidden knowledge. And I think of that as a metaphor for that precarious transition from girl to woman. And I'm really interested in examining that space in which a young woman, pardon me, is simultaneously empowered but yet still vulnerable from her newfound sexuality. So I'm using the Nancy Drew aesthetic and also this content kind of as a hybrid.
And in a lot of the photographs, it looks like they're either looking for something, or maybe they've lost something, or that something is either about to happen or just happened. How do you set those scenes?
Well, I love that. I love that about these particular photographs, because Holly took an issue that is sometimes explored in contemporary art rather seriously, and that is the transition from, say, transition to womanhood, and she found a very playful yet complex way to express those ideas. And for instance, in this particular photo, which is called Behind the Old Painting, you see a set of twins, which are actually a concocted set of twins, discovering something behind an old
painting.
What
do you mean that they're a concocted set of twins?
Well,
how
they're
do you
actually just one one girl.
So it's the same model.
It's the same model.
Places.
And then I've locked down my camera, and I've photographed her in two different locations, different gestures, clothing, etc., to try to convey that they're actually twins. And I'm, like a lot of people, I'm compelled by identical twins. I think that they're intriguing and mysterious, and I think that it adds to the mystery of the work that these two twins are kind of counterparts or accomplices in this discovery with the other.
And what if an adult happened into this scene right now? Would there be consequences for these girls?
Well, potentially. There's a lot of off-camera action. As you can see, some of the characters are looking off-camera, so that suggests that, you know, maybe there's a noise or maybe there's a person that has happened upon.
Are they doing something they shouldn't be doing?
I think that they're, discovering some sort of forbidden knowledge, and there's that impending threat. And they're, you know, potentially embarking on something dangerous, like, for example, a crime scene, but they're void of any gratuitous violence. There's never any murder weapons or blood or body. And I intentionally wanted to make them very innocent, because I wanted to offer up to the viewer that opportunity to kind of, again, create their own narrative about what it is that they're discovering while using very suggestive iconography.
Any of it autobiographical for you?
Well, I think all of my work, to some extent, is autobiographical. You know, I make art about what I know and my life experiences. And in this body of work, I made kind of a conscious effort to challenge myself to shift less from the personal narrative in an attempt to make my work more accessible. But I think that ultimately that's unavoidable. And the point of departure for this body of work was a conversation I had had with Fiona, who I've been photographing since she was 7 years old.
The actual model.
Yes, that's her name.
Yeah.
And she was telling me with so much enthusiasm that she'd been reading the Nancy Drew book books. And I too had read the Nancy Drew novels as a child. And although I couldn't recall a single plot, the provocative images were still deeply embedded in my mind. And I had been wanting to do a series where I depicted young women in more empowering roles. And of course, Nancy Drew, you know, the sleuth, is one of the few role models for young women.
And timeless as well.
Indeed, she's been around since the 1930s.
But speaking of timelessness, we're going to take a little break here and then come back and continue this conversation with Eric Schneider and Holly Andrus after this break on Outlook Portland.
Outlook Portland will continue in a moment.